passing through. Come on in, find a seat. There's still plenty. I'm Rabbi Silvers, this is Rabbi Bach. We're glad to be here. Our Cantorial associates here are Freudenberger and Cantor Stephanie Shore, who made it back from Israel, who made it back through the snowstorm in New York, all the way to be here tonight. Oh, wow. So that we can provide you with another stirring and wonderfully inspiring service for this Shabbat Shira, this Sabbath, this song. So, you know what? Maybe we should start with this. Why don't we, before we even get to all the music, there's a lot of musicians behind me. They're going to play a lot, but you're going to be able to participate as well. You're going to find everything tonight up on the PowerPoint presentations in front of you. On either side of the arc, thank you, Susan Linder, for the PowerPoint presentations tonight. You can follow everything up there, so you won't even need the prayer book tonight. But so, maybe before we get to all that, why don't you turn to each other and wish each other good Shabbos? Say hi. Introduce yourself to one another. Make each other feel welcome.
Thank you. actually, no, we're going to do something else first. It's Tu Shvat. It's the birthday of the trees. And it is absolutely wonderful to recognize that the trees give us so much. And we, in our faith, are so blessed to have a magnificent holiday that causes us to stop and recognize the blessing the trees give us each and every day. Each of us can remember, I'm sure, special trees throughout our lives, special gifts that the trees have blessed us with, either fruit or shade, or maybe a beautiful furniture or something very special that was made from special wood that came from a tree. You know, I don't really know of another religion that stops to have a whole holiday. We have Seder, we have Tu Shvat Seder, all around the blessing of trees, the gift of trees. So, to honor that, I wanted to sing this song so that we could take a moment and recognize Tu Shvat on this Shabbat Shira. The two always fall very, very close to each other in our calendar year. This year they fall simultaneously. So, we sing now something you'll find very, very familiar. And if you would like to, please join me. Trees of green, red roses too. tired, but I'm very, very much invigorated and rejuvenated by being there with my 21-year-old daughter, who I must just quell for just a minute and tell you that she graduated combat training with high honors. Only five from her troop of 80 received those high honors, and she also received her commander's beret, which is a very, very high honor. And so here I am, just having returned, and I remember, the vision. I can't remember it, I wasn't there, but feeling being in Israel and feeling the closeness of the ancients going out into the field and welcoming Shabbat. We're going to do it in a slightly different way now. But imagine, when we get to this last verse, with Goli v'shalom, atera ba'ala, gam v'simcha v'sachala, tochei monei al-segila, boi chala, come bride, we'll turn, we'll face west, we'll welcome Shabbos Friday. And we'll have an opportunity to envision that bride coming in as if we're welcoming the Shabbos. And when we do, remember that that's likened to God and God's love for the people of Israel. That love that binds us together all the time. Let's continue now.
Let's cantor. Before we do that, let's light Shabbos candles.
Oh, yeah, so am I.
Let's bring the warmth, the beauty, the fire of Shabbat in, and then that'll be the bride's cue to come through the door.
Yes.
So you can follow along with the PowerPoint presentation, the lighting of the Shabbat candles.
Please be seated. And we continue now with the Chatzi Kaddish, which can be found on the PowerPoint, if you prefer the prayer book, page 26.
You are so sweet in the heart of the soul.
rise and just chant Shema together. Shema Yisrael. to our synagogue home, and we're very, very blessed to have you. Thank you. You know, it's always wonderful to remember the gift of freedom when we come to this portion in our liturgy. And it was so wise of our ancient rabbis to canonize this into our service, because there is never a moment that we shouldn't remember the gift of freedom. Having just gotten back from Israel and really witnessing the daily challenge, you know, and that's a very minor word when it comes to what Israelis live with. The gift that we appreciate here of freedom. I'm sure that many of us recognize it because we keep up very, very intently with the news from Israel. But some of us might, and all of us, I'm sure at times, just go about our daily business without even stopping to think how fortunate we are. And so in our liturgy, to have this moment where we can remember. And then to remember that when we crossed that sea of reeds and Miriam took up this timbrel and the people rejoiced, it's really a remarkable moment. So the song that I picked for this absolutely reflects this joy, this inner feeling of awe, this inner feeling of absolute inspiration, of just having witnessed with your own life. I hope that you'll have a moment to think about the incredible gift of freedom and what it means to you in your life this day, this moment, right where you are. This life is so real.
Thank you.
It was just a few days ago. I was in at the hotel, and it was just before I started sobbing. How many people get to the hotel? Yeah. Right. So you know, I'm not concerned. It's one thing to have peace when everything is going wrong, it's fine, you know? It's easy, right? You have peace, you know, that life is going the way you want it to go, and you have peace. It's another thing to have peace when things aren't going the way that you wish them to go, or there's trouble in the world. It's hard to find that peace within. We get angry, we get frustrated, we get anxious. There's just a sense of uneasiness. Meditation helps, prayer helps. It is a gift to be able to come to a place of peace and be in a place of peace regardless of what's going on outside. There's a saying that says, wear the world like a loose garment. You heard that? Wear the world like a loose garment so that whatever happens, we still maintain that place of peace within. You know, there's a beautiful saying above our ark in the chapel. It says, that says, know before whom you stand. You know, if we always know before whom we stand, we can always kind of tap into that place of peace within. So no matter if there's rain or shine, we can always be in peace. Then we can begin to bring peace to the world. Because it has to start again.
Thank you. We continue at this time with our Sabbath finish on page 4 and 5 on the PowerPoint. And Brad Jacob will be leading prayers for us this evening.
The seventh day is consecrated to the Lord our God. With wine, our symbol of joy, we celebrate this day in its holiness. We give thanks for all our blessings, for life and health, for work and rest, for home and love and friendship. On Shabbat, eternal sign of creation, we remember that we are created in the divine image. We therefore raise the cup in thanksgiving.
Standing under the wedding canopy, the chuppah, be renewed by each day in faith and gratitude, and may his coming days and years bind you ever close to the love of his blessed by God. It is my honor, along with Rabbi Silvers, to offer the priestly benediction.
May God bless you and keep you.
May God
always
shine
with his face with great favor upon you both. Grant you many more years to come of blessed companionship, long life and health, of enduring and continuing love. And may God shower you both with his gift of peace. Amen.
Sing it up,
Shabbat Shira.
president of our congregation, Rob Siegel.
Thank you, Rabbi. Shabbat Shalom, everyone.
Shabbat Shalom.
Wow. What else can I say about tonight's service? The clergy, the choir, the band. Wow. What a way to welcome Shabbat. It's more like celebrating Shabbat. And that's why when I come in this building, it's always come be inspired here at CBI. If this is your first time worshiping with us, you know, like Cantor said, we do this all the time, every week, right? Maybe no, not really. But we do have wonderful and diverse Shabbat experiences here each week at Congregation B'nai Israel. And we're happy that you've chosen to be here with us tonight. There are so many reasons to come to CBI. I really need to mention just a few. You can join our sisterhood to bag toiletries that they will donate this Monday night in our boardroom that they can donate to people who are in need. You can come see a movie on Wednesday night with the Nagel Family Jewish Film Festival, A Life Apart. Popcorn, snacks, and a wonderful facilitator, so please join us. You can come on Thursday and see Dan Pepperman, our next CBI talk speaker. He'll share his thoughts with anti-Israel and anti-Semitic speech, especially on college campuses. And then you can come back next Friday and celebrate Shabbat again. And we will welcome a new Torah, which is being donated to us by Sharon and Ron Landau and their family. It's going to be a wonderful celebration. But wait, there's still some more. I need to mention a few more synagogue-wide events that I think that you would like to participate in. Mitzvah Day, this Sunday, you can still register and participate in three off-campus events, the Embrace Race at FAU. You can glean in Delray Beach, or you can come to Ebenezer, where we serve on Thanksgiving. We're going to do a community-wide barbecue there, and you can use all of your help. So please come out and join us there. We will also be hosting this year the Dubab Memorial Concert, featuring our amazing Cantor Stephanie Shore and our Cantorial associate, Sarah Freudenberg, as well as the talented Cantors of our partners in this venture every year, the Cantors of Temple Bethel, and the special guest star, Patty Linsky. You can get your tickets online at cbiboca.org for the special concert on February 19th. I'm almost done. Please join us for our biggest party of the year, the Speakeasy. It will be a great fundraiser here for CBI on February 25th. There'll be great food provided by VIP caterers, booze, and all kinds of great CBI experiences for you to bid on, all to benefit your synagogue home and mine, CBI. So join us often, and I welcome each and every one of you to become a member of our CBI family, whether you live here all year long or you're just here for the season. We want and need your support so we can continue to provide wonderful experiences just like tonight. And one more mazel tov to my cousins Rosalie and Joe. Look forward to celebrating your 60th anniversary this weekend with you. Shabbat Shalom, everyone.
You know, everything Rob had just shared with you is everything that's just happening in the next week or so. So there's a lot that goes on in this little Jewish community right here. We try to make sure we are a hub, a center of all kinds of Jewish life and experience. And as Rob says, it's not so easy to do. I know all of us feel a little bit entitled, we're a Jew, let's walk into the synagogue and let's enjoy it. But it requires support. Our ancestors understood that. We need to understand it. Our children, the only way they'll see it is for the support to be there. It is tremendously gratifying, I know, for all of us who struggle in God's vineyard to bring all of this to you. It is tremendously gratifying to see all of you here tonight. And whenever you choose to come, it is a blessing. And I hope and pray that this evening and all that we do, day in and day out, will reside with you as you walk out tonight. And you might consider, as Rob said, be a part of the family. Jewish people need to support one another, and we need to support the great institutions of Judaism, namely the synagogue. It is indeed a mitzvah, and we will not turn anybody away. So, I invite you, as Robin said, to come be a part of the family. Standing in the back of our room is our executive director, Mr. Steve Allen. Wave, Steve. If you don't know him, that's the man. Come and make an appointment. Come in and talk to Steve. We would be thrilled to open up our family and our family doors and open to one and all in our Jewish community. And if this hasn't been enough joy for you tonight, we're going to feed you as soon as we're done. Moaning Shabbat, the delight and joy of Shabbat. I'm telling you, I don't know about all of you, but I got plenty of calories just from tonight's wonderful service, the music, and before we conclude the Kaddish in our concluding number with the choir and the band and Cantor and Sarah, I do want to take a moment and say thank you. Thank you to the choir who's sat here patiently, waited all evening to share with you their joy. And we'll conclude the service. Thank you to this remarkable band. Peter, thank you so much. Peter works in the office, and Peter, your great love for this place is exhibited and new for us. And I know you do it out of the love you have for this place. Maybe I should put it this way. Not only out of the love you have for your dear wife, Cantorial associate, but your love for this place. And we greatly appreciate it, and we don't say it often enough. Thank you so much, Peter, for all that you do for us. It is well deserved. And to Sarah and Cantor, my, thank you both so very, very much for lending us your voice, your talent, your hard-working dedication, as Cantor said over this past year, putting this together and preparing. We are blessed to have two beautiful voices, two beautiful souls, and a remarkable representation here of Jewish leadership. This is Shabbat Shira. Cantor talked to you a little bit about it. We should understand the message is that hand-in-hand, Moses, Aaron, Miriam, led us out to freedom. You've seen the result of women tonight here in our congregation, Rabbi Block, Andrew Shore, Sarah Freudenberger, helping to lead us all in great joy and delight. And it's not just here at Friday nights or Saturday morning services, but it's day in and day out in the synagogue life. In the classes that they teach, Sarah does our junior choir. Cantor's been doing beautiful whole-hearted meditation concerts at least the last, 2 months, Cantor? Since October? Oh, my goodness. And so many of you have taken advantage of being uplifted and spiritually touched by Cantor and those concerts here. We work hard day in and day out to make a difference in your lives and in the lives of our Jewish community. And these women are tireless in what they do. And to all of you, thank you so very, very much, Rabbi Cantor, Sarah. Thank you very much from the bottom of our hearts for all that you've done here to share with us your hearts, your souls, your talents in tonight and for all that you do day in and day out. Everyone, as I said, cordially invited to join us next door for Kiddush, for Holy Shabbat refreshments. Tomorrow morning, do join me and Sarah, Robin, thank you. Robin and I will be leading the 9 o'clock early Torah learning service in the chapel tomorrow morning. Now, if by show of hands, I see how many are coming, I'll move it into here. Tomorrow morning, 9 a.m. in the chapel, we'll learn about this Torah portion of Shalach and pray a little bit together, a little bit more traditional modality tomorrow compared to tonight. But before we get to all that, we have the opportunity to do say hi next door. Oh, see, look at, I mean, Susie gave, sorry, Robin gave us a lot of announcements, and Cantor mentioned tonight, said beautifully, Tu Bishvat, the new year of trees. We planted a tree today with our preschool this morning, which was delightful and joyous with our little preschoolers. And I invite you, nothing supports Israel more than planting a tree in Israel. You'll see flyers next door for Tu Bishvat. Jewish National Fund, Keren Kayemet Israel, is one of the most important organizations in Israel today. It not only helps replant the forests that have been decimated by forest fires recently, but they also are bringing water to the Negev. They are blooming, they are creating gardens of green in the Negev. They are building resource centers in the Negev for those with disabilities. The Jewish National Fund does great work in your support by planting a tree in Israel. It would be greatly appreciated. $18, $36, it's a minimal investment to make in the future of the state of Israel. So there's flyers next door. Do take one consider doing that one for Israel. Okay, I think I've covered everything. Let's turn back once more on the PowerPoint. Zichronam Livracha, as we remember those whose lives have been a blessing, those who have given us life, those who have given us love, those who have died, love to Hashem, the sanctification of God's name. Currently, the Shiva is being observed for Bert Kleinman. Our condolences to our dear member Janet Kleinman and the loss of her beloved Bert. The 30-day period of Shloshim for Lou Baron, Adolf Edelman, John Iverson, Lester Statham, Ethel Goldstein and Harvey Birkhoff. Yord sites at this season for Joe Akers, Gerda Beiner, Neil Borg, Marshall Braunschweig, Raymond Brill, Elizabeth Cohn, Elizabeth Burstein, Helen Condon, Dora Crown, Doris Guidman, Sylvia Duggan, Francis Morgan, Isidore Furing, Bernard Finder, Margaret Fuldauer, Claire Garber, Alan Goldstein, Morris Gordon, Ruth Grandis, Edmund Hardew, Benedict Hyman, Helen Hyman, Seymour Jacob, Claire Jampolis, Henry Jarecki, Joseph Kaddish, Edward Kaplan, Steve Katz, Seymour Kogan, Fanny Krimsky, Rose Langdon, Brian LeBlanc, Eva Lieberman, Alice May, Saul Mayer, Max Forrest, Rose Orlinsky, Baynard Paul, Hyman Pearl, Joseph Horwich, Beatrice Rintel, Edith Rolnick, Irving Rosenwasser, Edith Rothschild, Ruth Sachs, Sidney Scheiner, Alex Schindler, William Schwartz, Avi Mori, Julius Silvers, Manny Skulnick, Howard Steiker, Eugene Sterling, Martha Sobel, Ruben Sonnenstein, Musa Toplitsky, Sue Ellen Wexler, Robert Traeger, Stanley Watsky, and Ann Yellen. If there are mourners amongst us, those who are observing Shiva Shloshim mourning work site, I invite you to rise at your seats this time, that we might comfort you in the words of our tradition. Hamakom Yirachem Hashem, Tov Shalalei Tzion Yerushalayim. May God comfort and sustain you among all who mourn in Zion and Jerusalem. Together as a loving, caring community of friends, let's all rise. As together we praise God, and we pray for the coming of God's kingdom. Hash. Yitgadal v'yitgadash sh'erabah. V'yamah v'yitgadah 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 v'yitgadah. Shalom, we ask Shalom. Aleinu, we are all Israel. on high, send peace and comfort to all who mourn and all who are bereaved, and we say, amen. Friends, please be seated. Cantor, Sarah, the band, and the choir will close it out for us tonight with a beautiful rendition of Adonai.
So before we conclude, I do want to add my thanks to the incredible choir made up of our beautiful members. Thank you so much. And our incredible band, thank you so much under the direction of David Gibble. And again, Peter, thank you. Sarah, thank you. And I just want to mention, what is it, a month from now, Mary Poppins Quorum. A month from tonight, need I say more? Okay. Dear heads, I trust my spirit, and sleeping when I did it, and when my body give it all to you, God is with me, I shall not fear. You are my rock through all kinds of trouble, a living God with no other devil. Power without end, and then you transcend your majesty. So no love, I share my love.
Thank you. Thank you.